Hello, welcome back for some more Pillars of Eternity, the White March. We're gonna kill a dragon. The Alpine dragon.
Let's see what lies this way.
Yeah, let's be sneaking. I realize some of you guys might be just tuning in to see how I do this. Hopefully I do beat him. A lot of this is gonna be winging it. Everyone's level 16 at this point. You can pause if you want to see what we have. Active effects. This is probably not going to be the best way to do it. I only have a few things in mind as far as, you know, what I'm going to be doing. Aloth. Stuff. There, of course. So what I'm going to be trying to be doing... Sorry guys, I'm getting over a cold. I got dragon meat. I got regen potions. I'm going to have two characters run up and engage the dragon. The rest is going to stay back. Hopefully out of range. I'm going to try to paralyze it. I'm going to use Durance's Devotion for the Faithful. Devotions for the Faithful, yeah. Fourth level spell to increase our accuracy for spells and melee to 20. It's also a debuff against, you know, whether it works against a dragon, I'm not sure. It would be nice. I've also got... some figurines I can use to summon things. Pelagina. And Canna. And if all goes well, hopefully I'll be fighting the Adra Dragon next episode. So... hopefully we can do this. So... as far as quick items, yeah, everyone has an Endurance potions, major regeneration. The iridescent scarab figurine. The Adra beetle is a level 8 beetle. Pretty good. I gave her some revival scrolls just in case we need it. Aloth. Ditto. Wizard's double. I'm probably going to forget some of the things I'm going to be hit. I'm definitely not going to forget paralysis, though. And Maelstrom is really freaking powerful. So, I like that. Regen, power, more endurance. Probably don't need that. He's got the scarab figurine. Spirit shield I probably won't use. Potion of power. The dragon meat. I realize you can probably, I think you can cook this into a dish and make it even more powerful. Or last longer or something like that. But I didn't bother to do that, so I've got two of these things, plus 45 max endurance, plus 3 might and resolve. It's gotta help. And Canna, I have him back up. He has a hailstorm. He's great with lore, so he can cast these high-level scrolls. And I gave him some scrolls. Scroll of Revival as well. So, and once he gets to enough, I'm gonna have him summon things. The first really good thing he can summon is the drakes. I believe it's two drakes. So I'm going to have him use that. And yeah, that's about it. There's a ton of like summon things here, so that are going to pop up. And when we start engaging the dragon, it's going to summon wraiths and specters and all that fun kind of crap. So hopefully these area effect spells, we can catch them in. The beetles will help. And, oh yeah, we've also got Council Heart. I friggin' love Council Heart. So. Right, I want to switch this crap out, actually. And yeah, it's probably, I don't know. I'd give her haste or something, but eh. We'll see if this works. Have everyone go over
here. No problem.
Yes?
Hey.
Bite into that stuff.
I'm ready.
I let her take it.
Hey. Hey. Hey.
Greetings.
Leave. Now.
I'm not even bothered talking to it. You guys can watch my old episode if you want to. Okay. Hopefully this works. I guess we're technically not in combat yet. Maybe now we are? Yeah. I'm only gonna be able to get these guys. Well, I wanna get Aloth in there. Ah, too far apart. But I don't want Aloth to get hit in the blast. Another blast is coming. Decisions. Okay, devotions for the faithful. Regen. Regen. And console hot. Can I give him the beetle? I forget who I gave that beetle to. You know what? I never used them before. I don't know. Maybe we can't use them from... Hold on. Slow spirits. Okay, he's got one of them. Okay, I forgot. I thought I gave it to Kana for some reason. Substantial Phantom would be good. Like, I don't have, like, ideas for everybody here. (Clears Yeah, substantial phantom. Who else is, is everyone accounted for? Except for Canna, I believe. He's just gonna hang out then for a bit. I'll have him take a regen just because he's not doing anything.
Hey.
The specters are here already. I'm gonna try to keep these two together. As you see, it's not working out. Crushing Doom, this thing's awesome. Oh, he's stunned already. He's still casting, or trying to cast. Yeah, it's gonna be a little messy. That's why I've got these guys with revival scrolls, in case we die. Barely injured. It was yet to go. You're attacking that. I should have gave him one of the beetles. Console Heart. His next move, Freezing Rake or whatever the hell it's called. Alright, she has one of the other beetles. These skeletons are really weak. I don't bother with them. I also want to get a chance to cast that Scalebreaker, but first... I have to cast... It's funny, the other one doesn't give me an option on what to cast on. Okay, so... Gonna see if we can do this. Who's this? Oh, Aloth duplicate. Oh, yeah. We'll try this. We'll try this delay of motion. I don't know if he can make it over there. Yeah, and all that crap. That will help. And now Aloth, if he can get over there, cast paralysis on this guy. She needs to clear a path. She's stunned. Alright.
Hey.
Yes, attack the Spectre. Is he chanting? I set up his chants. If it... They've undone themselves before? Wait. Yeah, he can't... Yeah, I got stuff here. Alright. Okay. Yeah, I'd really like to get rid of these effects. Constant recovery... That's from the regen potion, I take it. Oh, he's paralyzed. Yeah. Help the guy out. Just making sure everyone's going, everyone has a thing to do. How about Maelstrom? Oh, she's doing the beetle this time, I'm thinking. So she can reach him. She's stunned. Okay. Durance is stuck between the beetle. Oh, he's out. Where's that spell? Resurrect. I say Durance is out? Adair is out. Oh, she wasted that. Damn it. He's back. If I have to choose these two. And I do have to choose. Aloth duplicate. I guess engage that. And, I don't know. His number's not going up. This is because he's stunned right now. Okay, good. Now, if we can get rid of some of these bad effects, that'd be great. Aloth duplicate's almost out. What happened to this other beetle? Didn't work, apparently. Seem to be working right. Barely injured. Okay, you can run up and hit him now. Okay, Aloth. Paralysis. Oh, don't hit Aloth. He's paralyzed now. Excellent. Oh, I forgot all about, oh, he's paralyzed? Parasitic staff. Try to free those guys up. Unfortunately, knock prone from the blast doesn't work very much. There's something that pushes back, I think. If I can push that off of Aloth, amplified thrust. Just trying to free him up so he can get closer and do his work. As he's got some powerful spells to use. Kinda still doesn't have chance. Yeah. All right. Still paralyzed. All right. So hit him. Oh, we got rid of that thing. Good. Aloth. Maelstrom. He's stunned. She's stunned. Adair is paralyzed. Let me get rid of this thing. I'm not sure what else to do. Still paralyzed, apparently. Did we use it? Is he stunned? No. Oh, he's going with it. The dragon is regular injured right now. Paladin is actually fine. He got that off, I guess. Yeah. Cool. Sworn enemy. Oh, that's immune. I was looking at immune. I think he was not actually paralyzed. Let's see if we can knock him down. And these guys are free. Actually, get that one. We're gonna go again. Another scroll of Maelstrom. Oh hey, Scalebreaker. Oh my. Alright. Where is that? Resurrection. If you can get it off. Alright, Palagate is prone. There. I don't know if that'll work on him, but... We have one more of these paralysis. Let me try. You know, I wonder if I got... I hope I didn't get a dare in it before. Don't mind me, guys. I'm not exactly an expert. I'm trying my best, and we've got it badly injured, so I think we can do this thing. I'm just going to have him take that. I'm gonna have to take that. He's still trying to cast that. Oh, he's about to. That stupid thing. See if we can get rid of that thing. What is this again? Just in case you guys want to know what this stuff is, Ninagoth's Killing Bolt. Almost dead. And that's... okay, good. How much burn damage? Alright. Try that. Oh, here we go. I was waiting for that. A swamp spore. Here we go. It looks pretty small, but it's got a lot of health. Yeah, just keep attacking. we got here? Oh, it's near death. It's in the back. Yeah. Nice. Yay. As a dragon falls dead, essence erupts from its corpse. It seems as if many lives, or fragments of them, are returning to the wheel all at once. The freshest of these gives you the brief impression of a young man trekking through the mountains in search of... Before you can see the rest of the memory, the essence dissipates. Igadir came to the White March searching for his soul twin, but somebody killed him in the lonely mountain passes. I found the final wisps of his soul in the wilds east of Stalwart. I discovered that Igadir was killed by his soul twin, a dragon. I slew the dragon. We sure did. What kind of goodies? Oh, this is from the Ice Blight. More dragon meat. We'll use that against the next dragon.
You can trust me.
I'm glad someone can, Durance. Alright, sneak mode for goodies.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
I think there is something in here. I'm not sure. let's go faster. Something over there.
And the fire shows me something new.
Okay, so we got Durgan Iron Ingot and Durgan Cogwheels good for use at the White Forge. Oh. Here we go. Sabre Marie. Black Sanctuary. Hide Armor. Riona's Vambraces. A topaz, some silver. Oh, this is a saber, but this is a war bow. Grants confuse on critical hit. Sabre Marie was owned by an archer from the Valian Republics who fought for Deerwood in independence. When the War of Defiance began, many of the newly independent republics took up the cause and joined the battle to the north. The Valian had a longer and more melodious name for his bow, but Sabre Marie quickly became the local bastardization. No recorded histories explain where he got the bow, but plenty attest to its usefulness against larger forces. Quick, powerful shots fired from cover scattered and confused many Adiran units throughout the war. And Black Sanctuary grants warding seal when hit by a critical hit, 2 per encounter. Grants withdraw, 2 per rest. It's an exceptional shield. Though its maker's mark can be traced to an otherwise unremarkable smithy in Dawning, this shield earned its fame within the keeping of Polder Grint, a young Adiran lord whose fondness for dueling became the inspiration for many anti-Adir folk songs and plays in the time during and after the War of Defiance. Grint cultivated a reputation as a relentless and unbeatable foe, for whenever a duel seemed to be going poorly, he would raise his black shield and resume the fight with renewed vigor. Grint employed the shield to great effect for several years, until he finally found himself severely outmatched by a more experienced rival. Mistakenly believed that the shield could preserve him even at the precipice of death, Grint fled the field only to bleed out on the bank of the Is-Ian River. We've also got these Riona's Vambraces. Plus 5% of misses converted to grazes. 3 damage reduction bypass and plus 5 damage reduction I can slash. After Riona established her reputation as a fighter, she began joining adventuring expeditions. For years, she was one of the most sought after warriors in the Eastern Reach. That changed after an expedition to the White March. She traveled with a team of historians and treasure hunters, intent on breaching Durgan's battery. Yet their guide fell ill, and they became hopelessly lost in a blizzard. The snows continued for days, and their provisions dwindled. While the rest of the party camped in the lee of a cliff, Riona was sent to scout away ahead. She wandered into the storm, barely able to see the hand in front of her face. After hours of trudging through the snow, Riona stumbled into a cave. Yet instead of shelter, she found a young alpine dragon. I like this one. The beast was too lean, and its eyes burned with hunger when it looked at Riona. Yet she promised it a larger meal if only it would spare her. She led it to the hollow where the rest of her companions waited, and as the dragon turned on them, she fled. She lost the vambraces in the snow. That evil little thing. Dare you sacrifice your friends. I don't want the hide armor. Checking anything else. Nope. Okay. So now it's back off screen. I will go back to Cadnua and rest up, and then it's time to take on the Adra Dragon, and then it's time to finally take on Theos and finish the game once and for all. Thanks so much, guys, for watching. See you in the next episode, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.